Okay, so hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to use pen tool in Figma. So I'm just going to give you a basic hint on how to use and how to create some like basic diagrams or vectors by using this pen tool. So just open your Figma project over here. So if you're using any laptop, I would recommend you use external mouse to it instead of using only your touchpad, because mouse gives you a little bit, what to say, it gives you more accuracy and helps you in controlling your vector diagrams easily. So use mouse. So let's get started. So open a Figma project, and here we have our pen tool over here. So shortcut for pen tool is P. We just click P. As you can see here, our cursor turns to a pen. So if you aren't using, just go here and select the pen tool. Okay, so now pen tool, as you can see here, a small circle like thing up here. So just press left click your mouse, just drag it, and you will be getting a straight line, and release it. So as you can see, you can just create any curvy lines, okay, like this. So if I just again left click it and remove it, so as you can see here, so just control Z, so undo it. So as you can see, I will do it again, click it. So as you can see, our curved line has been created successfully. And suppose if you want to keep this curved line, what you need to do is just click done. Okay, so now we have got our own curved line, and if you just select this vector one, so this, the properties of this curved line aren't appearing here. Just click this vector one, and you will have layer and fill and stroke, etc. So if stroke is basically the width of our curved line, so if you just increase it, so it becomes like this. Okay, if I will just reduce it, it becomes like what, somewhat like this. Okay. And fill is basically, it can be used only when our vector diagram is connected, so it should be completed, or it should have a cycle like thing. And our plus, now right now our curve isn't like that. It's not in the form of a shape, it's just a curve. So we can't use fill over here. So if you want to delete a particular vector, you can undo by using Control Z. So basically, as you can see here. And suppose if you want to completely remove it, just select this vector and you can just click on delete. Okay, select and delete. That's so simple. And there is another tool also in this pen tool. We can use the bend option. Okay, I will give a live demo. So just click it, same thing, drag it and click it again. So we are getting a line over here. And suppose if I want to bend this line, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click this bend tool. Okay, so as you can see, the control has shifted to bend tool. So this bend tool is only available while using pen tool. As you saw earlier, this icon was in there, so only while using pen tool this bend tool icon is available. Just go to the center of our line and just left click. So you click right on the line, okay, and just move it. So you'll get a curve like this. Curve, you can move this curve up, down, etc. And you can just move, get more curve towards one side, and like this, a stylish design to the other side, and just increase the stroke. So looks really good, I think so. So this is like this. All this is also another way this can be done, and delete this one. And this can also be done without using any pen tool, by using only pen tool itself. I will show you a demo of that also. Just click and make a straight line. Just select. So as you can see, we are getting already some bend options over here. Just click it somewhere else, and the same thing that appears. Okay, without using the pen tool, it's available for us. You can just do like this any shapes. Okay. Like this also any shape. So increase the strokes. So basically you can do this also by using our pen tool. Okay, so the next thing is going to be like simple designs. Okay, so creating a rectangle, square, etc. So just create a rectangle. Okay, so you have to be very careful with the diagram. Okay, sometimes line can be slanting, so it will be very slow and while doing this. Okay, so as you can see, we don't have a rectangle, and we can just increase our stroke over here, and we can also add effects. We can drop shadow. So as you can see, we're getting a little bit of shadow. Okay, we can see the drop shadow over here. So we have inner shadow, drop shadow, layer blur, background blur, etc. There are many other options are available. Okay, and suppose if you want to add color, okay, to fill color. So as I told you earlier, our fill wasn't working when we are using that option, that we are only simple curve. Okay, it wasn't close, but we have our very own rectangle, and it has four vertices connected to each other, so it forms a cycle, and now color can be filled. So now it's filled with this grayish color, and if I change it, it gets automatically filled. Okay, so there's no need to worry. So just delete this vector. So these are some of the basics, okay? Really, really basic. So basically, these vectors are mainly used to create some, what to say, like some easy flow designs like that. Simple designs and like this rectangle squares for their web app or some, let's give some additional decoration to your project that you're creating. And you can also create a house using this simple house, okay, like this. Okay, one click and straight and like this. And from here, if I just create a triangle, come down over here like this, just left click, there's no right click, okay, just it. So we have done with our house. So this itself looks like a very good design. So as you can see here, this can be even used as a logo. And if you want to add color, and here is another interesting part, okay, our rectangle had only one, what to say, only one face, okay, that's a good word, only one face, and there was only one color possible for the entire face. So suppose you want multiple faces, you would have just drawn a line between our rectangle and used one color in one half and another color in another half. But here in our house, we have like three empty places separated by borders. So we can basically add here three colors. For adding colors, we have this option over here near this done button. Just click this, select this, and it will just show some cross lines, okay, when we place over a particular region. Just click this cross line and go here and select your color that's needed. I will select red here, so we'll be getting red, and just close it. If you want different colors everywhere, you need to create another vector, okay? So it should be a fresh vector so that you can create different colors, and you can just resize it in this manner. Okay, resize it. Okay. And suppose if you want to copy this, select this and Control D. So it basically duplicates another one. So as you can see, I have vector 2, I think. So suppose I will just move this. So as you can see, Control D, select the vector and Control D to duplicate. So if we have now two designs over here. So it's really good. I think it's very simple to use vectors, and you can also create another, so I'll delete this now. So you can also create other basic designs, like just use your pen, select the pen tool, left click your mouse, keep on left clicking, and just select a slanting or however it may be. I'm just going to give you a demo. Okay, just release your left mouse button and just select it. And as you can see here, you will be getting these two lines, okay? This line over here and this line over here. Suppose if you just move this line, okay? Okay, if you just move this. So as you can see here, you will be getting a curve. So we aren't using any pen tool over here, but we are using this line provided by the pen tool itself. So this it has also another point over here. So by these two tools, we can also create many designs. So as you can see here, I have created like a simple S-shaped curvy design. It looks really good, okay? Just do some changes also. Okay, so just go to, just click done and just increase some strokes. So this itself can be used as a design, so that's good. And suppose if you want to add, like, what to say, if you want to add more colors, okay, again just go to the pen tool, okay, and just click it and just draw a line like this. Let it be like decent straight, just on this, just join it with it. Okay, that's good. And come back over here. Come back over here and just put it out, okay. And connect it. So just click done. And as you can see here, our additional line has been added to our existing design. So that is vector 1. Our vector 2 is the latest design, and vector 1 is existing design. Suppose we select vector 2 and we just increase the stroke, so it kind of, it gets blended with that, okay? And you can even adjust like this, okay? So now it's little bit like clear. As you can see, little bit get, you can move the vector. So that's what I'm doing. There was actually some gap between both the vectors. I've just moved it, okay? Now as you can see, we can like this move the entire vector. So you can just move it and just, now I can see there's no gap, okay? Like this. star, anything, etc. that you're going to do. Okay, like this, anything. I think it looks like a star. Okay, something like interconnected. So there's very great potential by using this pen tool, okay? Something, use this star design. Okay, some star kind of thing designs, it can be done by using our pen tool. So I think these are just the basics, and in the subsequent videos I'll be putting some other web designs, how it can be used for desktop and mobile apps, something like that, some design ideas that can be used for your mobile or web development websites, etc. by using Figma. So that's it for the video. Now I also done many tutorials in C++, Java, Blender, so it's basically a programming channel. I've just tried out the video in Figma, and I've been learning for a month, so these are how I learned my basics in pen tool. Hope this video was useful. So do check out my other videos of my channel, Blender also, and in Unity also. Check it out. Subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.